It is Thursday, January 8th. The markets in New York are open on the big number this morning, $2.56 billion. That's total revenue reported by Family Dollar for its latest quarter. Now, while revenue rose, profit was cut in half, and Wall Street not too happy about that. The discount retail chain also seen its same-store sales. That's a crucial retail metric fall last quarter as well. That's when analysts were expecting it, in fact, to go in the other direction. Hello, everyone. I'm Dan Kleffler in New York. So here with the details to explain what's going on, Jeff Mackey from Yahoo Finance on this Thursday morning. Mr. Mackey, let's dig into the numbers here. I mean, how did Family Dollar do? Revenue's up, but profits down.
Yeah, you know, and this was really, really a miserable quarter out of these guys, Dan. I'll be honest. I look at a lot of retailers. To have that comp store sales number, and I know that's a little wonky, but that's really just how is your stores? They've been more open more than a year. So how's your day-to-day business going? To have that number fall this quarter, that is going to be anomalous to the rest of the retailers and the rest of the American environment for retail as a whole. That number dropped at Family Dollar. I hate to see that. This company is getting bought out. If it weren't, the stock would be getting hammered today. Really kind of bad news coming out of this discounter.
Well, then from its strategy, then how much can it keep cutting its prices?
Well, they're going to get bought. And so I think they kind of just hung a gone fishing sign out there for this fourth quarter or first quarter of their business, fourth quarter of the calendar year, and just sort of left. They can keep cutting those prices. They keep gouging into their margins. But a lot of these problems are Family Dollar specific. I know it's tempting anytime you see a company with this big a footprint doing $23 billion in business. It seems like that should be a statement on the American consumer. But in this case, it's more of a Family Dollar specific type of problem.
You talk about the fact that this is a bit of a takeover target. I will get it on this Thursday. Dollar General, Dollar Tree battling it out. Who looks like they're going to be the winner on this one?
Well, it looks like Dollar Tree is. Now, the reason that's controversial is Dollar Tree is paying $8.5 billion, whereas Dollar General, which is the big magilla of this dollar store market, offered $9.1 billion. And so that goes before shareholders relatively soon. And again, the shareholders are going to be voting whether or not to approve the deal. Perversely, having a terrible quarter might actually help that deal go through, because there's no guarantee that Dollar General will still be offering that $9.1 should the shareholders turn this off or down. It's really kind of one of those old-fashioned bidding wars with a dollar store spin on it.
All right, so what about the CEO of Family Dollar then, Howard Levine? What, is he backing the smaller bid on this one, or is it, his own personal survival?
I think it might be his own personal survival. The operations there suggest that he's not necessarily day-to-day, but Howard Levine built this company from nothing, and he's a little bit of a retail giant. Now, if they would have taken the Dollar General offer, if Family Dollar would have said, you know what, Howard Levine's going to take that 9.1, he would have been out of a job. He gets to stay on board in some capacity with Dollar Tree. The dark spin on it is that he's kind of feathering his own nest and keeping his job. He's a very wealthy man, a retail titan, and he's not young as a spring chicken, so I'm not sure how much that narrative holds. He may have just thought this was a genuinely better long-term play for some of the folks that work within the company at Family Dollar. In terms of how much they're going to have to downsize, Dollar General would have had to cut back more. They would have had to sell more stores, and that would have meant more job losses for the company that Howard Levine built. So the charitable explanation is that he's trying to save some of the jobs with the folks that he helped create. The less than charitable explanation is that he still wants a job.
Ah, I see. Okay. Well, we'll have to wait and find out exactly which motive is going to be driving this one then. But overall, investors then, what should we be doing then? Staying away from the Family Dollars of the world, this whole dollar industry? I mean, you got activist investors, Carl Icahn, Nelson Peltz, Paul Singer. They've been having their hands in the mix.
Yeah, and they kind of got lucky. They forced a merger here. Generally, investors, Dan, particularly when it comes to retail, they can look almost anywhere else. In the whole big world of retail, thousands of public retailers out there, they're releasing their same-store sales today as well. The results have been terrific. We saw a really strong fourth quarter, really nice holiday season, best in years. That makes these numbers from Family Dollar more disturbing. But in terms of what investors should be doing with the activists, just move along. These guys, the Carl Icahns of the world, are playing a whole different game than you and I and the folks on Main Street when they go out and buy their shares. It makes for a sexy headline, and it makes it nice and easy to digest the idea that these whales are fighting it out and the little guy wins. Just move along and maybe go buy shares in some other beaten down retailer, or buy Target. We started with Target. We can end with that. It's buy some Target, buy some Walmart, buy anything but Family Dollar.
All right. With the advice, we're going to leave it right there on this Thursday. Jeff Mackey from Yahoo Finance. Mr. Mackey. Have a good day, sir.
You too, friend.
Of course, you can keep up with the latest headlines right here on abcnews.com. You've been watching The Big Number. I'm Dan Kleffler.